Hey everyone, welcome. With the new T-Type transmission components pushing forward that 55 millimeter chain line, I thought I would do a video to talk about the difference between dub versus dub wide and whether or not they require different bottom brackets. So let's take a look at this. When dub was introduced to simplify our world, the dub spindles were the only thing that we had to worry about. And the only other sophistication that SRAM introduced or used was the 3 versus 6 millimeter chainring offset. And you guys probably remember that we've used 3 millimeter offset for boost and 6 millimeter offset for non-boost, so 49 millimeter chain line. Now, a bit of a hack if you want to get 55 millimeter chain line with the classic dub spindle would be to go third party chain rings that will provide you with that 0 millimeter offset as opposed to 3 millimeter. And that's how you get, again, 55 millimeter chain line with the classic dub spindle. Their new cranks launched with the T-Type transmission only come in 55 millimeter chain line, meaning that you automatically need to use this, the what's called dub wide spindle. But what's the difference between dub and dub wide spindles? And the diameter of these two is the same. It's supposed to be 28.99. There we go, 29 millimeters. But the difference is in the length of this spindle. I'm gonna remove the preload adjuster to make it easier. So here we go, 11.9 or 12 centimeters length. In comparison, the standard dub spindle, 11.4 millimeters. So we have a difference of about 5 or 6 millimeters between the length of the two spindles. And I know you guys are gonna ask me about the chainring that comes with the T-Type. Yes, it's direct mount with 8 bolts. And if you look here, this is also a 3 millimeter offset. So more options for you to adjust your chain line. SRAM put out a document that will tell you that there is way more spindles than just dub and dub wide. But one thing that I learned recently is that not only did they have different spindles, but they also recommend different dub bottom brackets for these. And if we scroll down on that table, you're going to see a list of the BB names, part numbers recommended, as well as the number of spacers included and what type of spacers. And if we take the threaded 73 millimeter bottom bracket shell, MTB or standard dub and MTB wide or dub wide, you're gonna see on the package itself, the different part number, 015000 on one side, 015005 on the other. These are threaded for 68 or 73 millimeter BB shell. If we open the box, dub on the left, dub wide on the right, the bottom brackets themselves are absolutely identical. You can see those 2.5 millimeter inner spacers that are included on both. But then what you're gonna have different is here, this set of exterior spacers. The dub, standard dub, is gonna give you what they say is 2, 3, and 4.5 millimeter spacers. And then on the dub wide, you have the 3, you have the 5, and you have the 7.5 millimeter. So that is the only difference between the two. As for the installation of these bottom brackets, how many spacers and where, if you scroll down on that document, you're gonna see this exploded view of the bottom bracket clearly specifying what spacers are needed for what type of bottom bracket. And for our MTB wide 55 millimeter chain line, you can see that we need a 3 millimeter spacer on the non-drive side and a 7.5 millimeter on the drive side of the crankset. Telling you that if you buy the wrong bottom bracket for this application, you will not have the appropriate spacers needed for the install. So dub versus dub wide specific bottom brackets, that 000 versus 005 part numbers that you saw on the list. Did you know of the existence of these dub specific bottom brackets? What did you use in the past? I would love to hear your guys' opinion. Let us know in the comments. Now, as you know, the almost 30 millimeter spindle introduced by SRAM was meant to simplify our world. But if you look at that table that I introduced to you, you can see that there is actually quite a few variants of both the spindles and the bottom brackets that they recommend. So all in all, make sure that you guys are well informed and take a look at that table before you order your next set of at least bottom brackets. So that's pretty much it for my video. Let me know if you guys have any questions. Hope you found this useful. And if you did, don't forget to like, subscribe, and comment. And until next time, hope to see you folks on the trails. Cheers, guys. Cheers.